been challenges, unquestionably, especially in the Syria situation. And you've seen that there was a meeting canceled between Obama and Putin, which was unfortunate for both sides, but it really was no way around it. The Snowden question also made things more difficult. So now what you're seeing in the United States is there's a division of view on Russia. Some, like folks like Senator McCain, are taking a pretty hard line, while others are taking more of a wait-and-see approach, which is really what President Obama is doing. You also saw at the meeting in St. Petersburg of the G20 that there was really there is room there for negotiation. And unfortunately for the United States, President Obama was not able to walk away with what he wanted on Syria. But yet, right now, there does seem to be an impasse between Russia and the United States on the Syrian question. Now, if the Syrian question can get left behind and can be resolved, there's definitely a room for negotiation. Russia's entering the WTO after a long wait, which is very important for that country and very important for its trade prospects as well as investment prospects. So I think as we get beyond this issue of Syria, Snowden gets forgotten about a bit unless there's more leaks, which Russia said there won't be, if that's true. So if there's no more leaks, Syria gets left behind, there's a lot of room for cooperation there. And then there's room for good investment opportunities for companies out of the United States into the former Soviet Union, to Russia specifically.